Okay, mungkin dia boleh berkembang, maksudnya dia grow kan. So it can be both. If we look into the true side, it can be it can cause negative side where pollutions, deforestations, climate change affected the biodiversity, or it could expand much better. Yeah, when conservations happen, bila kita buat preservations, and this can be the effects to the biodiversity. So this biodiversity include ecosystem, genetics and cultural diversity, and the connections between this and all species. Okay, so biological diversity refers to all of the different kinds of life on Earth, and it's also called as biodiversity. It's often used to refer to the total number of different species on Earth. Okay, sama juga lah tadi eh. So all sources termasuklah terrestrial, marine, aquatic ecosystem, mangrove areas, terrestrials and ecological complex of which they are part. And this also includes diversity within species, between species and also their ecosystem. Ini definisi ikut Conventions on Biological Diversity 2003. So pada pendapat you all lah, perlukah kita biodiversity ni? Penting ke biodiversity ni kepada kita? Why? Is it important? Or it's nothing to do with us? Is it important? Do we need biodiversity?
Yes.
Okay, why? Why do you need biodiversity?
Sebab dia support semua dekat dalam Earth ni.
Okay, what do you support? Support sistem apa? Support apa yang awak maksudkan tu?
Macam ekosistem, aquatic punya semua.
Okay, that is in terms of aquatic life, yeah? Untuk awak, perlu ke? For the human like us?
Makanan.
Makanan, semua makanan kan? Ha, you all baru lepas pergi bahari raya. Okay, lagi? Makanan, apa lagi?
Air,
okay, alright, good. Air, quality of apa? A clean air. What else? Remember, second chapter, resources kita ada apa? Food, air, apa lagi? Water, minerals, apa lagi? These are come from biodiversity, but the biodiversity must be at a good condition lah. Okay, the water, air tu, kalau air quality is at bad conditions or the AQI is at red punya apa? AQI tu dalam condition yang dangerous, so it can affect the our daily life lah, kan? Kesihatan kita pun, kita je fauna and flora. Okay, so refers to the variety of life form commonly expressed as the number of species in an area or the number of genetic types in an area. This is according to Watkins and Keller 2005. Or biological diversity juga is a measure of the relative diversity among organisms present in different ecosystem. Contoh tadi ala desert, terrestrials, mangrove, these are different ecosystem. So you bolehlah bagi definisi yang pelbagai, and also you can give examples too. Okay, so biodiversity, there are three kinds of biodiversity where sometimes the people, the researchers or scientists said essential to preserve the ecological system. The first ones are genetic diversity, species diversity ataupun ecological diversity. Selalunya ecological diversity dia akan disebut sebagai habitat diversity lah. Okay, so genetic diversity measures variety of different versions of same genes within individual the species. Okay, different species, genes dia, rupa dia, bentuk dia, warna dia, Species diversity measures number of different kinds of organism within individual communities. Meanwhile, ecological diversity access richness and complexity of a biological community, forests, grasslands, streams, lakes, oceans, aquatic streams, banyak lagi yang boleh disebutkan sebagai habitat. Okay, species diverse apa? Pelbagai species, contohnya ikan, ya, crab, semua tu tinggal di different types of ecological diversity. Tinggal di mangrove area, tinggal kat desert area, tinggal kat tropical forest ke. Okay, so these are examples of kinds of biodiversity. Genetic, species and ecological diversity. Okay, so kalau contohnya genetic diversity, the different genes, okay, warna dia, yeah, patterns dia, species, different type of species, crabs, different species, birds, different species, jenis dia, ecosystem ataupun habitat ataupun ecological, it's just the same, okay, menunjukkan a specific area that the fauna are living, okay, a given unit area. Okay, so these are genetic diversity yang disebut tadi tu lah, refers to the variations of genes within a species. Contoh kita tengok kat atas ni adalah jagung, so different colours. Okay, we can see brown or purple, orange. Okay, bukan sahaja dari segi jagung je, fruit sahaja, vegetable, but also manusia, haiwan, okay, plants, vegetables. So contohnya you nak buat research ke nanti, you can go into genetic diversity. Itu pun dah banyak sangat yang you can discover. Okay, this is what it said by genetic diversity. Okay, characteristic data. Alright, so genetic diversity, they make individuals of the same species different from each other because of its color, because of its shapes, okay? And it's very important for groups of plants and animals, including us, to have genetic diversity. So it allows groups to adapt to the changes in their environment. This could be something like an outbreak of disease or a change in the climate. This is genetic diversity. See? Kalau in terms of animals ataupun snails, for example, this one have different colours, shapes on the snails tu. Sama jugalah macam manusia dan juga haiwan, flora and fauna. Fauna and human. Sorry. Manusia samalah. Kita pun ada yang different colours, different shapes of nose, mancung, besar ke kurus ke, kan? Besar. Same with animals tu. Okay. So kalau habitat diversity boleh juga disebut sebagai ecological diversity ataupun habitat ecological ataupun ecosystem. It's just the same. So different kinds of habitat in a given unit area. And there variety of biological communities or ecosystems in a given area. If you still remember, last 2 weeks we looked into mangrove, estuarines, ecosystem yang ada apa pelbagai dia punya habitat, maksudnya apa, species yang tinggal dekat dalam ekosistem tersebut. Alright, this one is just example. Okay, so diverse of habitat garden. Ni kita akan tengok dalam chapter forest nanti. Kita akan tengok different layers of forest tu ada berapa layers. Yang mana yang paling dense. Yang kalau contohnya tropical rainforest ada berapa layer. Yang mana banyaknya fauna, dekat mana, daun mana yang daunnya lebih lebar, kecil, saiznya, yang mana trunk of the trees are woody trunk. Ni kita akan tengok dalam tajuk forest nanti. Okay, chapter 5. So the third one is species diversity. So it refers to the variety of species in a certain regions and also varies greatly among taxonomic groups and among geographic areas. So basically they have three qualities, different three under species diversity. Contohnya satu adalah species richness, the total number of species. Second is species evenness, the relative abundance of species. And paling common yang kita selalu dengar adalah species dominance, the most abundant dekat certain area. Contoh, sebab saya selalu sebut mangrove, sebab saya selalu dan mangrove sangat hampir dengan saya. Maksudnya saya selalu buat research on mangrove. So basically kalau dekat mangrove area, contohnya kita sebut apa? Bila orang sebut it's paya, kawasan paya, of course it's most dominant mangrove, kan? So we know the species dominance at a certain ecosystem macam tu. Okay, so these are the diversity of species on Earth. So basically ada pelbagai sangat, pelbagai species dekat atas bumi ni. So kalau contohnya you nak sambung master nanti, species tu ada pelbagai. Contohnya nak jadi pakar untuk burung, kan? Burung sahaja untuk jadi apa, how they actually look after their babies, how they feed their babies, how they actually live in their habitat. Itu pun dah ada banyak yang kita nak kena study. Itu baru bird saja, belum kita tengok fish ke, marine life, belum kita tengok other species, banyak sangat, kan? So basically there's more than million species that have been discovered and named, while scientists think that there are, banyak lagi yang you boleh discover. So untuk pelajar PAMS, you boleh lah. Kalau contohnya nak jadi sambung untuk you punya area, untuk you punya kepakaran, so you nak tengok specific species, you can go to species diversity, look into any specific species. Okay, how their habitat, how they feed their babies and so on. Okay, selalunya untuk bidang kita, untuk bidang taman, ada bird expert. Macam mana dia jaga dia punya babies ke dekat dalam taman, dekat forest area yang kita tengok. Okay? Okay, this are species diversity. Ada pelbagai lah, ya. So, mammals, reptiles and so on. Okay, these are also different species untuk daun, ya, atau pokok lah, ya. So we can see they are different, dia punya bentuk, different colors. Okay. So species richness is simply the number of species present in a sample or community or taxonomic group. So basically, numbers of different species represented in an ecological community ataupun any landscape or any region. Okay? Ha, ni contoh je lah nak menunjukkan. Contoh gambar saja. Okay? Species evenness. Okay. Species evenness maksudnya equal. Contoh kalau kita tengok dekat dua forest, forest A and forest B, the amounts of orchids are equivalent at forest A and also forest B. So it's species evenness. So species evenness is a diversity index, a measure of biodiversity which quantifies how equal the community in terms of numbers. Okay, so for example, if there are 40 foxes and 1,000 dogs which means that the numbers are not even. So basically, kalau 40 foxes and 42 dogs, it's almost even. Okay? Almost sama in term of numbers dia. So kalau yang paling ni, nak kata dia even, 40 dogs and also 40 foxes. Ini contoh saja, tapi taklah nak kata in terms of 40 dogs ke 40 foxes. Itu nak bagi gambaran saja. Kalau contohnya, kita bagi pokok species lah dekat satu kawasan. Contoh pokok mangrove kat sini, jumlahnya dengan dekat area species lagi satu kawasan. Ataupun as given pictures in the slide. Okay, species on the diagram A. Okay, if you see here and species in diagram B. Okay, mana ada yang mana satu adalah high in term of its species evenness dan sebab apa? Can you explain that? Which is species evenness that is high or low and why? Faham ke soalan tu? Ke tak dapat? Okay, antara diagram A and also diagram B, which represents or which shows the species evenness that is high and why?
Diagram B.
Okay, why is it so?
Because of kalau in terms of color dia, yang warna yang pekat tu sama banyak dengan yang cair.
Okay, you're presenting in terms of colors. Thank you for your response. So basically kalau contohnya dia akan sebut dalam satu gambar, so why or which area adalah higher species evidence, you can explain in terms of the species dalam satu kawasan tersebut. Okay. Lower species is on A sebab dia punya tu tak sama even. Itu contohlah kalau contoh dia bagi diagram untuk you explain in term of evenness of the species. Okay? Alright, so these two types of ecosystem vary greatly in species richness. Okay, so an example of very high species richness is a coral reef on the left side. Okay, kita memang tahu dekat kawasan ni, kalau contoh kawasan aquatic, coral reef, very dominant, okay, with a large number of different species. On the other hand, if you see on the right side, okay, aspen tree, and also has a small number of different species or low species richness. Okay, kita memang nampaklah contoh kawasan tadi, kalau kita sebut mangrove area, kawasan paya, so kita tahu ialah pokok mangrove areas. Okay, contohlah, okay. Species dominance, the species that predominates in an ecological community, particularly where there are most numbers, paling banyak. Okay, so example, tidal swarms in the tropicals are usually dominated by species of mangrove. Okay, ni mangrove area lah. Okay, ni contoh juga nak bagi tunjuk yang mana paling common. Okay, sebenarnya saya plan untuk buat aktiviti lain dalam kelas kita face to face hari ni. So, kita just lecture macam ni je lah hari ni, okay? So, this diagram illustrates the major components of the Earth's biodiversity, one of the Earth's most important renewable resource and a key components of the planet's natural capitals. So, sama juga yang masa tadi tu, in the first few slides in the beginning, so we can see there's three, okay, which are species diversity, ecological diversity or genetic diversity, okay. So kalau species tadi, the number of abundance of species present in a different community, okay. Ecological, habitat ataupun ecosystem. Kalau genetic is a variety of species, genetic materials in terms of colors, shapes tadi, okay. Or functional diversity is the biologicals or chemical process such as energy flow and matter recycling needed for the survival of species communities and ecosystem. Okay. Alright, ni adalah example tadi ecosystem, forest, wetland, savanna, river, deserts area, aquatic areas, species, different type of species, fish, crabs, snails, frogs, birds, and many more, okay? And genetics is because yang tadi tu different sizes, variety of diet, big size, small size, climatic conditions, okay, disease resistance, colors, okay, and many more. These are examples of the three biodiversity tadi, okay? So, as we know that biodiversity is very important to you, important to the fauna, important to everybody. So what does the biodiversity do for you? Apart from giving you food, apart from giving you air, what else does biodiversity give to us? Biodiversity ni adalah such an importance, very crucial for us. It's not just in terms of food only, it's not just in terms of air. What else does it give to us? What does the biodiversity do for you? What does the biodiversity do for you? Selain daripada memberi makanan ataupun sumber makanan kita dan mendapat udara semua tu, apa lagi? Besar ni biodiversity ni.
Dari segi ekonomi kot.
Ah, okay. What do you mean by economy?
Kita macam kalau pokok kan, kita boleh buat meja, kerusi, perabot, and then kalau daripada gunung-gunung kan, diorang boom buat tile apa semua tu. Kalau dari segi laut pula, sumber ikan and then sumber rumpai laut ke, so on lah. Kalau pokok pula, buah-buahan ke, macam tu lah kot.
Good. Okay, in term of economy, we do export, import, not just in term of export, import and export from the resources that we have that you just mentioned. Contohnya apa you sebut tadi, pokok tadi untuk kita buat apa resource, ambil sumber daripada timber untuk buat perabot, untuk kita buat apa pembangunan, ya. Yeah? Itu adalah another thing that is very important, which is the in term of economic. Selain daripada itu, kita juga menjual hasil sumber ini dan kita menjual ke negara-negara lain. Contohnya, kita ambil minyak, beras,
sawit,
ya, yeah? Palm oil, palm plantations, okay. Apa lagi?
Tourism.
Excellent. Ha, pelancongan. Kita pergi ke luar negara untuk melihat biodiversity yang berada di luar negara. Malah people from overseas come to Malaysia to see and pay for the biodiversity that we have. They pay is apa untuk tengok, untuk pergi apa hiking, untuk pergi apa, untuk pergi camping. So that's the things that we should value. Okay, biodiversity kita sangatlah rich, kan, kita boleh bangga pada pempal kita kat luar negara. What do you have in Malaysia? Biodiversity kita adalah nature, that's why we have to conserve. Parks and amenities student ni kena jaga alam nature ni, kan. So kalau kita apa nak dah apa nak pergi healing ke, kan, kat mana? National park, pergi gunung-gunung ke, kita nak pergi tempat-tempat tu. But if one things that we're looking at nowadays, people are looking very closely, is that people are doing more developments. They are doing apa tu, poaching. So these resources, these biodiversity are at a dangerous situation, which means that it can cause extinction. Kita sekarang ni relax je lah sebab kita pergi kelas, kita attend hari raya. Bila kita berada di industri nanti, bila kita berada di luar sana sebagai engineer, sebagai park manager, then we know that our resources, our biodiversity is at a danger condition. Maksudnya orang nak ambil, nak buat development, ya. Yeah? Orang nak ambil poaching. So biodiversity is very important. Okay, tourism, economic, what else class? Apa lagi? Itu dia punya main things. Economy, tourism. What else does the biodiversity do for you? Banyak ni.
Tapi ada dua lah. Ada jadi lah.
What does the biodiversity do for you? Okay, I have two. Can I have another two? Answer before we go to another slide. Two more. We have economy. We have tourism.
In terms of fight diseases.
Okay, what do you mean by fight diseases?
Kita tahu kan sumber biodiversity ni kan, dia ada certain species yang boleh kita gunakan untuk rawat penyakit secara tradisional apa semua tu. So orang dulu-dulu kan lebih banyak gunakan sumber-sumber asli ni untuk rawat diorang punya penyakit and maintain diorang punya health and lifestyle.
Okay, thank you very much for your answer. So, in term of medicines, kan medicine ni boleh bagi terbaik pada dua, the traditional ataupun kita pergi ke farmasi ataupun kita pergi rujuk doktors ataupun dan dapat ubat. Kita boleh rawat menggunakan traditional, menggunakan herbs ataupun sumber-sumber plantings. Sebab tu poaching tu, orang tak poach hanya yang selalunya kita dengar orang poaching binatang, wildlife kan. Tapi kadang-kadang orang juga poaching, jual ya. Yeah? Jual, boleh poach this traditional plants. Okay, traditional plants dan dijual, import, export these things. And doing it illegally. Okay, so health or medicines, okay, malah yang ubat-ubatan yang kita ambil daripada farmasi, yang kita dapat daripada klinik tu pun sumber dia daripada biodiversity juga yang telah diproses kan. Apart from, as you just mentioned, from the traditional herbs tu yang kita cari. Kadang-kadang kalau kita pernah dengar orang rawat untuk kencing manis, rawat cancer, they can get from the biodiversity. Maksudnya ada ulam, apa, ada daun-daun yang tertentu yang boleh digunakan untuk rawatan. Okay, as a part of the initiative. So kita ada economy, ada tourism, ada untuk medicine. Can I have one more? Last one before we can go to the next slide. One more. Okay, one more. Apa lagi? Biodiversity do for you. Economic, tourism, health or medicines? Boleh tak? One more. One more. Rasa-rasa apa? As a food lah kot. Kita tolong yang tadi tu kan. Food tadi. So kita dapatkan semua makanan kita. Contohnya fruits. Okay. It's for our daily life. Kalau tak, kita tak larat pun nak pergi class because it's for our energy. Ataupun macam mana kita nak sambut macam pelajar AP tadi, sambut hari raya, resource tu. The food, where does it come from? From the biodiversity. Walaupun dia telah pun dah jadi kuih-kuih raya semua tu kan. It's from the biodiversity, sumber tersebut. Okay. Alright, thank you for your response. So ini adalah contoh health benefits. As mentioned your friends tadi, contohnya untuk kesihatan kita dapatkan sumber-sumber tersebut ataupun secara directly yang belum diproses, herbs tadi, daun-daun yang tertentu untuk rawatan ataupun kita pergi ke farmasi ataupun kita pergi ke clinics, hospital to get the tablets, okay? In term of health benefits, supplements, semua tu, human needs, we need water, we need clean water, we need clean air, we need food, okay? And community well-being, kita perlukan environment biodiversity yang bersih untuk our daily activities, untuk our well-being, untuk kita pergi bekerja, untuk kita pergi belajar, eh? Spiritual values, okay? Spiritual values is like for us to go for healing, for us to untuk bersukan, okay? Securing our future, we need to conserve, we need to preserve the biodiversity that we have. To preserve, okay? The biodiversity that we have, so that our future generations, our children get what we have right now. Tak adalah macam kita yang sekarang tak dapat, yang dulu. ancestors kita dah ada kan. So then you don't want the things that we have today become extinct. Okay, itu sikit saja. Malah ada yang kau-kau sebut tadi untuk economic, tourism, that's apart from what we can get from the biodiversity. Okay, like food centering, okay? Medicines, yeah, about 40% of the pharmaceuticals used in the US, yeah, manufactured using natural compounds found in plants, animals, and microorganisms. Not just that country, in fact, all the countries, even Malaysia, we get resources from the biodiversity to produce untuk rawatan dan seterusnya. Okay, ni yang kawan awak sebut tadi tu kan, untuk herba tadi. Okay, so kita ada plant species, okay, for nature's pharmacy. Their scientific name, contohnya cinchona, rosy periwinkles, neem's trees, yeah. Okay, treats to variety of humans' diseases, okay. So bukan kita, maksudnya dia sangat precious lah, tapi kadang-kadang ada juga orang poaching these herbs untuk jual sebab dia very rare, right? Okay. So industrial materials, as mentioned by your friend, untuk development, dia ambil untuk ambil timber, untuk buat bangunan, untuk buat tables, yeah. So building materials, fibers, yeah, dyes, resins, gums, adhesive, rubbers, and also there is enormous potential for further research into sustainability utilizing materials from a wider diversity of organism. So mungkin kita punya bakal-bakal engineers ni nanti dia boleh menggunakan bahan-bahan yang industrial materials yang friendly environment. Ada tak contoh? Contoh. Friendly environment. Sebelum ni kelas saya, dia pernah bagi tahu kat saya, pelajar mungkin dah habis kot last sem, last semester, yeah. Part 8, dia kata dia ambil bahan-bahan sisa-sisa waste dan boleh dia innovate, change it into new materials untuk buat apa, bricks. I don't know how the process goes, but that is what one from your senior lah kot kan, dapat 8 last semester. So any of you yang current buat FYP, bahan-bahan untuk industrial materials ke, yang friendly environment, ada tak? Ada tak yang boleh share? Tak ada buat yang setakat ni?
Macam kalau saya guna palm kernel shell, yang waste punya shell dia tu letak dalam konkrit.
Macam mana tu?
Palm kernel shell.
Coconut apa?
Kelapa sawit, biji kulit kelapa sawit.
Okay.
Kita guna balik, dia waste, guna balik letak dalam konkrit.
Okay. So maksudnya dia friendly environment jugalah kan? Is it your FYP? Very interesting. Sebelum ni tak pernah lagi dengar yang guna kelapa sawit. So yang ni you baru buat ke ataupun dia maksudnya new innovation?
Yang tu tak innovation, tak new lah. Yang kita orang just new dia, kita orang tambah wood ash, gantikan semen sebab semen kan dia produce untuk dia akan greenhouse lah.
Very interesting. Okay, so gunakan kelapa sawit dan menggantikan di brick. So that is also part of the building yang membantu environment. Bayangkan our new development, our new buildings yang dapat menyelamatkan. Tadi siapa yang cakap tu? You punya project siapa? Siapa?
Husna.
Husna, ha? Project Husna. Berapa banyak bangunan yang bakal dibina adalah hasil daripada innovation or product daripada Husna, IR Husna, ha kan? It's actually a good thing you have contributed to the environment, ha kan? It's good. So apa lagi yang ada yang pelajar-pelajar engineer ada buat selain daripada Husna punya project ni? Ada yang ni tak yang related to industrial material? Ada lagi? Siapa tu buka? Ni boys ada siapa nak sharing satu lagi? Ada? Tak ada. But it's actually from waste yang siapa tu?
Saya buat natural fibers jadi landfill punya tanah.
Macam mana tu? Dengar sangat.
Macam apa? Macam bahan-bahan terbuang fibers macam empty food brush tu saya pakai balik untuk jadikan landfill punya tanah untuk kawasan pembuangan sampah.
Bahan terbuang daripada mana?
Daripada sawit juga.
Oh.
Okay. Empty food brush. Betul kan?
Okay. Bahan terbuang daripada sawit jugalah. So sekarang ni kita banyak sawit di Malaysia. So you're using some of the waste from the palm. Yeah, palm oil. So then you use it into the industrial materials which can help the environment by replacing some of the materials from the materials that could build the buildings, developments and so on. Very amazing lah you punya project. Kan? Terbaik kan? So adik-adik yang daripada AP ni boleh dengar ideas daripada bakal-bakal engineers ni. So kita, these are some of the things. Kadang-kadang orang buat, dulu saya pernah juga buat daripada apa, ambil daripada sugar cane. Saya pernah buat dengan USM buat projek untuk innovation. So waste daripada sugar canes tu, kita waste kita buang je ataupun kita boleh compost from the sugar canes. So we take up the waste from the sugar canes. So kita guna dengan apa, guna resins, kita guna dye semua tu, and then kita change into tiles kan. Kita buat tiles ke ataupun kita buat partition instead of using other materials yang kita beli dekat market tu yang boleh harm the environment, but this one kita reuse balik hampas tebu tu. Ini apa sama juga macam project you all tu lah. You guna sisa-sisa buangan palm oil, kelapa sawit tu guna dalam industrial material. Tapi itu lagi hebat lah sebab bangunan sekarang ni bangunkan bahan-bahan yang boleh meningkatkan greenhouse effects, boleh menyebabkan increase of the climate change. So your ideas, hopefully the new generations, the new engineers, pakar-pakar engineers dapat membantu alam. Apart from our part, kan, CF, pelajar-pelajar AP dia menggunakan konservasi, membantu dengan preservation. Okay, kita membantu dengan buat konservasi, membuat preservation. So these engineers membantu dengan menukarkan with their innovation, with their ideas, dengan waste-waste ni kita menggantikan ataupun substitute dalam materials untuk pembangunan, development. Okay, itulah biodiversity kita sangatlah penting. Tapi tak semua orang nampak benda tu penting sebab kita pergi ke pasar, ada je bahan-bahan tu kan, terus je. We don't think about pollution, we don't think about climate change, we just read it. Tapi apa kita punya actions? Okay, so apart from that, our biodiversity can help give us crop varieties. Kan, every day you all makan beras, nasi kan, makan nasi setiap hari. Tadi pun makan nasi, buka puasa makan nasi. Sambutan Hari Raya makan nasi, sambutan Waisak makan nasi, semua Christmas makan nasi. So what happens if we don't take care of the environment or the biodiversity, where can we grow the paddy? So that is the thing, kan? Tapi kita lupa kadang-kadang tu kan, manusia. Okay, and the most important thing for us, okay, kita dah habis je kan, kita dah habis bercuti seminggu, best kan cuti, kita pergi leisure, kita pergi look at the culturals and aesthetic value, pergi OOTD, baju raya cantik, semua tu, okay. So, but what that is the biodiversity can contribute to us, but then not everybody sees nature something that should be conserved. Some people see nature or green areas, dia nampak okay, ini tempat untuk pembangunan yang baru, kan, dia akan nak cut down the trees ni, cut down je this green space, sebab they don't value, they don't think it's important. So biodiversity is very something that inspire us untuk kita go for nature hiking, eh, camping, kan, nature lah, so untuk leisure. So this biodiversity is very important to us. So they can give us fruits, semua tu lah, okay, apa tu, resources. Tapi isu dia adalah when activities such as burning, deforestation, yeah, soil erosion, because when they do deforestation or logging, this can cause the apa, harm to the biodiversity, extinctions to the biodiversity. Okay, so biodiversity ada juga threats dia lah. So tadi dah kawan you mention pun climate change, pollutions, eh, deforestations, and threats to biodiversity contohnya adalah habitat destruction. Kita tak nampak benda tu, kita tahu development saja, kita sukakan kepada urbanization. But do we ever, have we ever thinks that, have we think that the biodiversity is important? Kita boleh je cakap macam ni dalam kelas, kan, penting. Tapi apa action kita? Macam Husna tadi, dengan siapa tadi? Lagi seorang? Husna dengan? Buat yang pump tadi?
Haris.
Haris, contoh Husna dengan Haris adalah action dia membantu alam dengan menggunakan ataupun their ideas, innovation daripada palm oil tu membantu untuk new innovation, so someday their products will be sell at the market untuk membantu alam. Yang lain macam kita ni, macam saya ni, macam kita tahu je, tapi adalah kita buat macam project, kan, kita membantu. Contohnya macam dulu saya pernah buat apa, menggunakan hampas tebu tu, kita buat new innovation yang dapat membantu alam, ataupun recycling. Nampak je recycling tu benda yang biasa, benda yang alam recycle, tetapi this can help to reduce threats to biodiversity, kan. Nampak macam, alah, takkanlah 3R tu bukan threats to biodiversity. Simple things, tak beli 20 cent plastic bags is also a contribution to avoid from the threats to biodiversity. Tak nampak pun, tapi sebenarnya itu membantu biodiversity kita. Selain daripada yang contoh dalam kelas kita tahu je, kefahaman je, ya, baca set macam saya sekarang ni, tapi apa action ni sebenarnya? Yang tu yang kita nak sebenarnya, bukan kita faham je. So action dekat rumah kita buat tak composting? Kan? Kita buang tak sisa-sisa kita? Yang dekat depan ni, apa, fabric recycle tu saya tengok dah penuh dah tadi. So maksudnya adalah action from the students, from the staff, kita boleh letak kat situ instead of kita just throw in the bin. So where is the action? Kita nak action tu sebenarnya. Selain contoh kita tahu, nak action. Some people, they know but they don't care. Itu adalah big gap dia. Kita selalu tengok apa gap dia sebenarnya. We are knowledgeable but where is our action? Kita faham, kita dah baca banyak buku, tapi mana action kita? So these are threats to biodiversity, habitat destruction because of huge pressure from the world, rapidly increasing population because of urbanization. People nak apa? Nak dah bertambahnya populasi, maka kita naklah tempat tinggal. Tapi tu yang Haris and Husna buat idea untuk sekiranya population bertambah tetapi dapat menyelamatkan alam, dapat membantu reduce, okay, threats to biodiversity dengan idea from this palm oil waste, kan, palm oil waste tu tadi, okay. So contoh lain, global climate change. Kita tahu benda ni berlaku, global climate change, banyak dekat timeline Facebook, banyak dekat newspaper, banyak dekat news lah, berita kat television. Tapi apa action kita sebenarnya? Apa action saya? Apa action saya yang sedang cakap ni? Itu yang kita pentingnya. So contohnya lah, kelas kita ada 41 students right now. Apa contribution kita? For example, today kita tak menggunakan plastik. Itu adalah contribution because we can help the to reduce threats to biodiversity. If 41 of us can help not to buy 20 cent plastic bag for today, it does help to control the threats to biodiversity. Okay, apa lagi? Habitat fragmentation, yeah, reduce habitats to support species, pollution, introduction of pollutants, okay. Mesti kena tegas dari segi EIA documentation tu. Okay, kena tengok screen betul-betul approval dia. Over exploitation, people are doing it illegally. Ha, ni yang kita nak ni. Okay, alien species when people introduce new species and this can cause predators to the area. Akan menyebabkan kesan kepada apa ancaman kepada fauna ataupun flora ataupun living things pada tempat asal dia. Okay, disease reductions in habitats, so this can cause spread of disease and many more. This is very serious. Okay, sekadar kita dalam kelas ni, kita baca-baca, dia tak efek sangat. Sebab itu, kalau contohnya kita punya individual project tu nanti, dia akan memberi kesan kepada kita dapat data. Dapat data maksudnya you akan tahu seramai mana, even though it's only 30 respondent, you boleh dapat tahu pelajar ataupun people tahu tak pasal plastic pollution. You tanya orang. Ini adalah real data, maksudnya you tanya kawan-kawan, do you know about waste treatment for example? Itu you tanya, dia tahu ke tak? So you are doing it in real project. Bukan sekadar kita baca saja, you dah baca, but then you doing it in real life, asking people, do you know about this? Do you know about, yang contoh saya pernah tunjuk dalam first class hari tu kan, example of their initiative, innovation ideas after they find out the problem, the gap. Okay, itu contoh. Okay. Alright, these are example. Okay, example of the issues berkaitan dengan environment. Sorry. Alright. So, for example, bila berlakunya deforestation, yeah, bila berlakunya logging, so these animals are being affected. Kita tak tahu benda ni. Kita tak nampak sebab kita berada di universiti. Kita berada di rumah. Kita tak terlibat secara langsung. Tetapi sebenarnya apa tindakan kita sepatutnya bila berlakunya development, bila berlakunya development, pernah tak kita terfikir this wildlife habitat dia terkesan atau tidak? Melainkan contoh memang dibuat plan, they are taken to a proper conservation area. Contoh orang hutan diletak dekat proper conservation area. Gajah, yeah, elephant, they take into proper. Kat mana kawasan-kawasan conservation area dekat Malaysia? Kat mana? Untuk animals, example.
Pahang.
Kuala Ganda. Kuala Ganda, kan? Itu tempat elephants tu kan? Saya pernah pergi. So, you boleh tengok lah. Itu maksudnya conservation area, they should be very happy. They are being taken care. Yeah, bagi makan. Yeah, maksudnya kalau contoh dia they are taken properly and taken care. How about the other elephants yang terbiar, their habitat dimusnahkan? Mesti dia akan risau. Yang saya pernah cerita dulu kan, contohnya sebelum ni buat apa tu yang ada ular belakang tingkap pesarahnya dulu kan. So sebenarnya kita memang takut ular tu ada dekat tingkap kita, tapi mana punca dia datang? Mungkin dia rasa juga terancam, so dia cari tempat yang selamat untuk dia protect diri dia kan, termasuk dia bawa dia punya ex dia tu bawah apa, letak dekat bawah apa, saya pernah dengar letak kat bawah apa longkang dekat bawah apa FSPU dululah sekarang tak ada, tu baru-baru masa construction kan, so dia pun nak selamatkan anak dia. Okay, apart from Kuala Gandah, mana lagi kawasan-kawasan conservation area? Mana lagi yang famous yang selalu kita dengar? Kuala Ganda. Mana lagi? Mana lagi?
Sepilok orang hutan.
Sepilok orang hutan dekat Bukit Merah pun ada cakap kan? Then you cross naik boat tu. Itu sebab tak pernah pergi juga itu lagi. Pergi Bukit Merah je. Okay, sepilok orang hutan, Kuala Ganda. Apa lagi ya? Kita ada?
Dekat Lancang.
Lancang apa eh?
Tiger Conservation Center.
Tiger Conservation Center, Turtle Conservation Center, rasanya kat Lumut kot. Kan ada tempat-tempat tu. Tetapi mungkinlah dia perlu dikembangkan lagi. Kita tak pernah fikir, kadang-kadang kita macam leka. Kita mungkin terleka dengan urbanization. Kita terlalu leka untuk nak menikmati, untuk mendapatkan commercial center, untuk mendapatkan ICT, untuk mendapatkan apa LRT. Tapi sebelum-sebelumnya ada pokok, pasti ada habitat dia, pasti ada fauna. Where did they go? Pernah tak kita terfikir? So itu yang kita nak kena reflect baliklah. Kena fikir juga ada juga binatang-binatang yang terancam disebabkan kita punya demand need. So mungkin kita boleh buat, tetapi kita kena fikirkan, kena fikirkan alternative or the plan management where to place them. Contohnya conservation center. Kena letakkan tempat-tempat yang selamat untuk mereka teruskan kehidupan. Tak adalah yang berlakunya dekat tepi-tepi, dia cari-cari tempat dia, berlakulah kemalangan. Tetapi sebenarnya dia punya tempat dia dah terancam disebabkan manusia yang mengganggu habitat dia. Okay, so poaching ni lah yang dia punya punca dia. Poaching ni adalah hunting ataupun harvesting. Okay, bukannya animal saja tapi wild plants tadi tu. Yeah? Contohnya herb-herb tadi tu. Okay, through hunting, harvesting, fishing or trapping. So why poaching is done? So poaching is done for large profit gain by the illegal sale or trades of animals, parts, okay, meats and also pets. So because there demand, ada demand tu lah. Yeah. Sometimes it's not because of lack of education. Itu kadang-kadang orang tu dia ada education tapi dia tak heran, dia tak kisah, lack of concern, lack of awareness. They don't care. Kadang-kadang you pergi tengok kenapa orang tu buang sampah tempat pada tempat yang tidak boleh buang sampah. Dia tak kisah. Itulah gap dia. Itulah problem dia. So this is the things that we have to educate people. They know. They have high education. They have diploma. They have degree. They have PhD. But sometimes they don't care. Okay. So ini ada benda yang kita nak discuss lah. Kita nak share pada people. Not just that. Kita nak dia kisah. Ambil tahu. Okay. Okay, tengok gambar-gambar ni. Menakutkan. But this is a reality. Kau tak dapat daripada internet tu. Ada. People poach because of money. People just kill it. Not just taking it, tapi dia kill, take the sumber-sumber tu sebab dia boleh dapat money. They don't care. Asalkan dapat money. Kan? Ada orang-orang yang macam tu. Okay? Ni lah. Ya? Poaching ni selalunya kita dengarnya macam ni lah. Elephants, ya? Rhinoceros, ya? Orang ambil. Tapi herbs ni juga adalah sangat famous, ya? Wild plant species, ginseng, ya? Galets, black cohosh ni antara yang famous lah, selalu yang orang ambil jual, kan? Kaya lah, orang nak kaya kan? Tapi kita nak implement, kita nak bagi tahu kepada orang supaya sayang pada biodiversity ni. Later on, we want to conserve what we have right now so that we can still use it. Kan? Tak perlu lagi nak kena fikir something untuk substitute. Nanti kena fikirkan apa nak menggantikan yang sedia ada. Okay, so rhino poaching statistic bertambah. Ya? Bertambah dan mungkin satu hari nanti dia dah berkurang disebabkan kuantiti dia dah berkurang. Bukan sebab berkurang tu sebab orang dah kisah. Tapi mungkin dah berkurang disebabkan kuantiti dia berkurang So quantity dah berkurang, so the numbers are decreasing. Okay, so we hope that the quantity, we can still help to conserve what we have right now. Okay, so we still can have some of the ideas to help to conserve the biodiversity. Yeah, kan? Contohnya apa? Okay, saya baca yang ni, some of you give me more ideas later. So kita jangan introduce invasive plant species, ya, ataupun alien species tadilah. So dia boleh jadi predators. Okay, never release exotic pets, ya, fish or turtles into the wild. Plant only native species, ya, avoid using pesticide. Okay, no pesticide. Kadang-kadang kita guna juga pesticide ni, chemicals ni. Kalau kita tak ada guidance pun, mungkin dekat kawasan-kawasan orang yang terlibat dengan agriculture, how do we want to help the biodiversity to increase their awareness to reduce the usage of pesticide or chemicals. Kan? Selain itu, apa lagi tips yang kita boleh guna? Yang kita boleh terlibat mungkin 3R tu lah. Recycle, reuse, apa lagi? Apa yang kita boleh buat? Sebagai seorang pelajar, sebagai seorang yang belum lagi di industri, yang macam maksudnya, yang kita, apa yang kita boleh buat? Contoh tadi, pelajar CF, apa you punya projek tadi ni masa jamuan hari raya tadi? Apa ada terms dia, saya nampak dalam poster tu? Poster. Poster ada, poster. You ada mention. Supaya semua pensyarah bawa bekas sendiri. Ha, itu contoh dia lah. Kan contoh dia punya inisiatif, nampak simple tu, nampak macam menyuruh orang untuk bawa bekas, bawa bekas, nampak macam suruh orang bawa tupperware, tetapi sebenarnya it's an initiative to help the environment, biodiversity. So these are the examples, nampak simple inisiatif tapi dapat membantu environment. Bayangkan kita punya macam Parks and Amenity Management student berapa ramai? Dekat berapa? Setiap mungkin dalam 500, 300 lebih kan? So how can you imagine kita buat jamuan raya, 500 orang pelajar membawa bekas masing-masing, tepui masing-masing. It does help the environment. Itu contohlah lagi. Okay? Nampak simple tapi nampak macam tak ada impact yang besar kan? Tetapi sebenarnya it does help the environment. So issues related to biodiversity, ada banyak sangat isu. Yang ini yang you punya project group task ni nantilah. Okay, so nanti next week you boleh bawa tajuk, dah boleh dah tunjuk apa you punya progress dalam group task tu. So next week kita akan buat quick session lah dalam kelas. Okay, untuk yang pelajar CEE, akan jumpa dengan Puan Aislina. She will create your poster and also your individual task juga. Okay, so because of that, kita ada overdevelopment, deforestation, pollution, global warming or climate change. Lagi apa tajuk yang you all ni, sekejap saya tengok. Contoh lagi apa ya yang you all punya tajuk ni. Chemicals and hazardous waste by Husna, noise pollution by Fatin, Elia, waterborne disease. Ha. Ini ya, issues dia. Kalau you tengok kawan-kawan you punya tajuk sehinggalah apa 46 ni, semuanya isu yang serius berkaitan dengan biodiversity. Okay, landslide, greenhouse gases pollution, emerging contaminants, semua tu lah. Tapi ini adalah individual project. Itu belum group project lagi. And these are all issues because of human juga. Punca dia kita. Kita. Okay. So because of human activities, the North American passenger pigeons became extinct. Okay. So this was the last known passenger of pigeon died in a zoo in the United States city of Cincinnati, Ohio. Ni orang hutan ya. These are endangered orangutans, yeah, shown in a rapidly disappearing tropical forest habitats. They are decreasing in numbers because the tropical forests are being chopped down, are being logged. So the numbers are becoming extinct, yeah, because of the human activities. So their habitats are affected, okay? People wants to do more agriculture, people wants to do more plantations semua tu. So of course dia akan affected lah. Tapi the amount of bilangan dia dekat apa sepiluk tu pun tak tahu berapa banyak kan. Itu adalah inisiatif yang kita nak bantu untuk conserve the numbers of orangutan. Okay, ni jugalah, okay, banyak juga yang spesies yang telah pun extinct, ya. Contoh ni lagi satu adalah Hainsi Matkau. Betul ke sebut tu? Ha, okay. Sources of beauty and pleasure. It's also being extinct, ya. Yeah? Sebab people are taking it illegally. Poaching lah, poaching. Okay. So apart from that, ada isu-isu juga disebabkan semua ini tadi, ni sebahagianlah sikit saja yang disebut kan. Burung pigeon ni, orang hutan, burung parrots ni, eh, disebabkan people are taking resources or people are doing illegal activities. Forest, deforestation dan juga menyebabkan environmental destruction dan menyebabkan erosion, landslide, flood, kan. Yang kita juga sekarang ni risau bila benda tu berlaku kat kita, contohnya banjir, bila berlakunya landslide, barulah kita mencari punca dia. It's better to prevent than doing managing, because managing is very hard. As I told you before, kan, managing took a lot of money, cost a lot of money, dan juga menyebabkan apa yang perlu dah berlaku kerosakan yang tinggi, ya. Yeah? So it's better to for us to reduce or increase the awareness among people. Okay, so ni contoh yang berlaku dengan okay coral reef yang dah jadi bleaching, coral bleaching. Sebab tu kadang-kadang this is because apa, coral bleaching berlaku disebabkan from warming ocean waters. Kan dia berlaku lah coral bleaching. Sebab tu kalau saya selalu pesan kepada pelajar, contohnya pelajar PEMS, dia akan ada marine subject. Marine subject dia akan pergi untuk coral planting. Tu inisiatif daripada pihak kita untuk bantu aquatic or marine area, marine parks. Kita berlaku untuk coral planting. So bila you pergi diving ke, bila you pergi marine area, kita selalu pakai sun cream, kan? Kita selalu pakai sun cream untuk kita jaga kita punya kecantikan, untuk kita nak jaga protection diri kita. Tetapi pernah tak kita terfikir ingredient of our sun cream tu akan akan memberi kesan tak pada aquatic life? Sebab tu kena be careful. Kita rasa nak selamatkan diri kita, maksudnya you kena be careful. Apa yang kita pakai chemical tu, dia tidak berkesan kepada aquatic life. Okay. Kadang-kadang kita pakai kan untuk diri kita. Sekarang kita lupa kita rupanya ada aquatic life, contohnya fish, eh, and so on. Okay. Apart from that, invasive species juga menjadi punca kepada this extinctions of life. Yeah. Contoh ni, diver explore the seabed in search for tropical algae. Yeah, near the Croatian islands of Faro, okay, tropical algae of the Cypripedia family has spread into the Adrian Sea and is gradually threatening to disrupt the native ecosystem. So these are invasive species ataupun alien species tadi. Bila dia datang, yeah, bila dia akan menjadi predators dan mengancam kehidupan ataupun habitat species yang tempat asal dia. Okay, dia boleh menyebabkan extinction lah. Ataupun terancam lah um, biodiversity tersebut, biodiversity di situ. Okay, so kita perlukan konservasi. We need to do conservations. So pelajar-pelajar AP lah kena buat ni. Ha, pelajar Parks and Amenity. So they are ingenious, dia punya actions dengan membantu menggunakan contohnya pump tadi, pump oil waste tadi, waste from other materials tu. Hampas-hampas yang contoh hampas tebu, pump oil, waste daripada sampah sarap pun dia boleh recycle. Dia initiative in this in that way. So in your part untuk Parks and Amenity, you have to do conservation. Conservation of biological diversity ada dua. Yang pertama adalah in situ conservation. Yang kedua adalah at situ conservation ataupun nama lain adalah offsite. In situ onsite, at situ offsite, sama je. Yeah? So kalau in situ ni ialah process of protecting an endangered species of animals or plants in its natural habitat, either by protecting or cleaning up the habitat itself or by defending the species from predators. Maksudnya, contoh saya dekat College Alam Bina sekarang. So contoh pokok yellow flame dekat Alam Bina, dia terancam. Disebabkan apa? Contohnya ada kulat dekat pokok dekat tepi ni. Kan pokok tepi ni, pokok tepi bangunan College Alam Bina ni terkesan. So saya dengan gardeners rawat dekat situ sahaja. Dekat situ lah. So it's on site or in situ conservation. If pokok yellow flame dekat tepi college ni dia attacked by disease, attacked by apa-apa fungi ke fungus ke, so kita bawa dia ke tempat lain, kita bawa dia ke botanical garden ke, kita bawa dia ke mana-mana away from its natural place, so ini akan disebut sebagai at situ conservation. Okay, let's see a pictures. Ada pictures tak? Okay, kejap eh. Ni pictures dia. Kalau in situ, tempat asal. Kita rawat di tempat asal. Tempat rumah dia asal, if it's at situ, kita bawa di tempat yang lain. Contoh botanical garden ataupun seterusnya. Okay, so contohnya, kalau conservations of biodiversity through estimation of protected area, contohnya national park, wildlife sanctuary, biosphere reserve, marine reserve. Okay, tetapi in situ and at situ ni dua-duanya penting. Kan? Sebab kadang-kadang dia tak sesuai untuk dipindahkan. Dia nak tempat asal dia. So kita buat tempat asal lah. So kita kena rawat di tempat asal dia, rumah asal dia. But sometimes these animals or these plants are not suitable to treat at its own natural area. So kita pindahkan. Sebab contohnya kalau kita biarkan, dia akan terus akan diserang oleh fungus ataupun any threats tu. So kita kena pindahkan untuk selamat dia daripada extinction. So these are the difference between in situ and at situ conservation. In situ kita rawat, protect it at its own habitat. Okay? Its own protecting these plants or animals its own habitat. Where else? At situ we bring it into another area. We move and take to conserve the plants or animal into another area. Okay? Okay, tak ada apa-apa, just mangrove and tsunami. So mangrove tu adalah satu yang very important. So dah dapat dah tak untuk dua benda ni? Two types of main conservation, in situ conservation and at situ conservation. Boleh? Anyone boleh repeat pada saya apa beza in situ and at situ? Anybody? Last one? Apa dia in situ dengan at situ based on pictures? Contoh pokok yellow flame yang telah diserang oleh fungus. Macam mana kita nak rawat dia? Atau macam mana kita nak selamatkan dia? Anybody? Husna?
Bawa ke at situ conservation.
Macam mana?
Bawa ke ex situ conservation kalau tempat yang dia membesar tu banyak fungus, so kita buat keluar lah daripada tempat asal dia.
Okay, kalau in situ?
In situ macam original tempat dia.
Okay, tempat asal dia. Kita rawat atau kita treat dia tempat asal dia, where it is belong. So at situ kita pindahkan, contohnya kita pindahkan ke botanical garden ke, kita pindahkan ke zoo ke, untuk dia selamat, untuk dia continues to expand. Okay, good. So ni yang you kena tahu, the different types of conservation, which is in situ and at situ conservation. Okay, ni terms related lah. Okay, terms related ni contohnya exotic species, sama juga alien species, invasive species, nama je. Okay, endemic species is a species that is native to a particular area and not native elsewhere. Cosmopolitan species is a species with a broad distribution occurring all over the world wherever the environment is appropriate. Ubiquitous species that are found almost everywhere, contohnya adalah human, E. coli, yeah? Itu yang biasalah. So itu adalah contoh ubiquitous. Okay, so yang ni yang contoh-contoh yang kita nak tengok gambar, kita tak naklah dah tengok benda tu berada di museum, tak naklah orang gembira dengan berlakunya buatnya deforestation, logging. It's not something to be proud of because we need to conserve the environment. Okay, urbanization is important but conservation is important too. So your idea yang untuk contoh yang you nak substitute kan, menggantikan tadi waste tu, itu adalah apart from the initiative, from our initiative to help the environment. Sebab tu kita sekarang kita fikirkan apa cara-caranya untuk kita selamatkan environment kita. Kan? Okay, so apa yang kita dah tengok pada hari ini adalah the importance of biodiversity. What is biodiversity? So biodiversity meliputi semua living things, environment, ecosystems, everything that lives in it, flora, fauna, animals and so on. And there are three biodiversity. Sebutkan tiga kinds of biodiversity class that are commonly usually dibincangkan oleh scientists. First one is genetic.
Genetic diversity.
Second,
species diversity, and ecological diversity.
Okay, ecological ataupun habitat ataupun ecosystems, it's just the same. Okay, thank you for your response. Okay, alright, so ni contoh tadi, and then we look into apa threats dia kepada biodiversity. Contoh climate change as mentioned by siapa tadi, your friend tadi, and then pollutions, yeah? And this biodiversity also give help, give contribution kepada kita. Contoh kawan yang sebut tadi, ecotourism, economic health benefits, yeah? Untuk spiritual well-being dan banyak lagi. Okay, and then the two things that we look at was two types or methods of conservation. Sebutkan two types of conservation, two ways of conservation.
In situ conservation dengan ex situ.
Ex situ conservation ataupun on-site ataupun off-site. Okay, so itu yang kita telah bincangkan pada hari ini on biodiversity. Setakat ini faham ataupun ada benda yang nak tambah untuk dikongsikan? Okay. Okay, okay, kalau okay, tak ada soalan. Okay, minggu hadapan, please bring me pelajar-pelajar CF dengan saya lah. So, pelajar engineering bawa pada Madam Ajlin, ya. Madam Ajlin akan bersama awak. You bring along your individual topic task dan juga you punya draft of group task. So, mungkin she wants to have a look. I will have a look at your task. So nanti kita akan kelas tu pada hari yang sama, cuma lain kelas je. So insyaAllah saya ada rezeki saya nak jumpa juga my engineering student. Okay, sebab sebenarnya hari ni plannya nak jumpa face to face, ada aktiviti, tapi tiba-tiba sebab tengok kelas semua digunakan, tak ada space untuk kita ni kan. So kita buat online lah, tak apalah. So next week kita jumpa, please bring me your individual task punya draft dan juga your progress of group task. So I can create, tengok apa yang boleh advice for you to work on it. Boleh kelas?
Boleh.
Boleh.
Okay, so kita akan jumpa minggu hadapan. Walaupun saya tidak mengajar minggu hadapan dengan pelajar CE, tapi insyaAllah kita akan jumpa sekejap lah. Macam hai-hai ke kan, nak tengok macam mana rupa Husna, macam mana rupa Haris, macam mana rupa Adam. Ha, okay, so tak apa, kita jumpa minggu depan insyaAllah. Please take your attendance. So kita jumpa minggu hadapan pada hari Rabu insyaAllah. Okay.
Okay, thank you, madam.
Okay, thank you. Can you please take your attendance for today?
Right, sure.
Thank you, madam.
Untuk tutor yang dekat dalam your future hari tu, saya lupa nak submit sebab saya ingat hantar after raya.
Nanti saya tambah bagi mana yang tu saya, kejap saya cuba buka bagi extend lah.
Saya pun tak sempat submit tak. Sebab tahu-tahu dah tutup lah.
Kan saya bagi sebelum hari Jumaat sebabnya lepas raya you all takkan buat biar lepas raya. Ha, kan? Tak apa. I'll try to open it to extend the dates and then you can upload it. Okay?
Okay, thank you madam. Sorry lambat.
Okay. Thank you very much for your feedback. Respond in my class. Nanti kita jumpa minggu depan face to face.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Bye. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, madam. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, madam.